There is breaking news from the Middle East, and this is significant. It is getting hotter there. Syria and Iran just last hour threatening to retaliate against Israel after Israeli fighter jets reportedly launched an airstrike inside of Syria. Remember just a few days ago, a top Iranian official saying that any attack on Syria would be considered an attack on Iran as well. This is the area of concern right here. But as for this story today, just keep an eye on this part of the world here. We can advance it one time. We'll show you what we believe happened here, okay? Here's Syria with the capital city, Damascus. This is about where you find the borderline at present day between Israel and Syria, the Golan Heights. It's believed that there was some sort of storage facility right here, southwest of Damascus. And in addition to that, there could have been a convoy on the move and destined for Lebanon, which is where Hezbollah is stationed. Now, we'll go back to the bigger map one more time because I want to bring in KT McFarland on this. In this whole section here, whether it's Syria or whether it's Lebanon, Israel to the south, Jordan as well, which has been very quiet lately, which is a little unusual given the Arab Spring, and then Egypt down here, and specifically the area of the Sinai Peninsula, which bumps up right against Israel to the south. With that, KT McFarland, Fox News National Security Analyst with us, and good morning to you. It was a pretty striking thing to get the reports yesterday afternoon about two hits inside of Syria, and then today we get the headline from Iran and Syria suggesting that it will retaliate against Iran, or rather against Israel, my apologies. Where is this going now?
Well, first of all, I think Syria's got a lot of trouble dealing with its own internal situation. I don't think they've got the bandwidth to retaliate against Iran, against Israel. But now the important thing to remember is Israel and Iran are preparing for war. I don't think they've made the decision to go to war, but they are both pre-positioning themselves for that. To go back to your map for a minute, Iran isn't next to Israel, right? But Iran has allies that are surrounding Israel, as you very well pointed out on that map, Bill. And what they're doing, Iran is doing, is reinforcing all those allies. They're reinforcing Lebanon, as you pointed out, on the Gaza Strip to the west of Israel. They're reinforcing. And the Israelis are trying to attack and pre-attack, preempt any ability of Iran to retaliate. So things are heating up there. Nobody knows where it's going, but boy, is it heating up.
It is said that perhaps this was a storage facility for chemical weapons, unconfirmed.
Unconfirmed.
Perhaps this was a convoy that was bringing anti-aircraft missiles into Lebanon to help Hezbollah defend off against an attack against Israel. That was not confirmed either. But what we do know is that something was hit by somebody. And if you're the Israelis, would this not be the perfect time to do that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Syria is so entirely distracted with its own civil war.
Syria is distracted. Whatever happens, Israel cannot allow those Golan Heights area, which they fought over for years. You know, the last several wars have been over the Golan Heights. They cannot allow Iran to use its cat's paws on the Golan Heights to have chemical weapons, to have anti-aircraft, to have missiles. If you remember, in the fall, in October, Gaza, which is on the west of Israel, there were Scud missiles, Iranian Scud missiles, being reinforced and put there. The Israelis attacked those. If you'll remember, a week before that, there was a weapons plant in Sudan, in Africa, that presumably the Israelis hit. That was a plant making weapons that were on their way to Gaza. So this is all heating up.
In all of our discussions over the past month or two, you consistently come back to that Sinai Peninsula.
Yeah.
And you say at the moment it's like the Wild West.
Yeah.
How?
Well, it's an area that is very sparsely populated. I mean, who lives there? Bedouin tribesmen live there. And the Sinai Peninsula, in the 67 war that the Israelis fought against the Arabs, and in the 73 war, that was the crucial area. That was the area where the Israelis moved in, the Egyptians moved in, back and forth. They fought over that for years. Now, in 1973, my boss, Henry Kissinger, made a deal. And the deal was with the Egyptians. You have a peace treaty with Israel, and we will give you military equipment. We will give you economic assistance. But we want that Sinai Peninsula to be demilitarized and safe. And now what's happening is that the Sinai Peninsula is being populated by Al-Qaeda. They're setting up shop.
So it's anybody's game.
It's anybody's game.
And that's the route into Gaza, which threatens Israel yet again. Yeah. One more point on all this. And I mentioned Jordan has been relatively quiet. If that goes, I mean, that was a friendly, has been a friendly neighbor to the east. Mm-hmm. But what are we doing right now? as a government to put our influence to make sure that this thing does not go very bad quickly?
Well, that's the big question. And I think that's why the hearings this morning with Senator Hagel are so important. Because where is the administration? Are they a strong supporter of Israel? They talk about it, but they don't act like it. Are they going to tell Iran? No, they tell Iran no nuclear weapons. But what are they going to do to stop Iran? So I think this is all these things are coming together in one place.
Thank you. We're going to wait for that comment here from Chuck Hagel. KT McFarland, thanks to you.